friends, welcome to another session on triangles, and we are discussing now similarity criteria for two triangles to be similar. So if you remember, when we were discussing similarity, we said that there are two criteria which when fulfilled can ensure that two geometric shapes are similar. Obviously, the two geometric shapes have to be of the same category, that is, you can't really prove a triangle to be similar to a square. If you take two triangles or quadrilateral or pentagons, hexagons and things like that, there are two conditions which have to be fulfilled for the two geometric shapes to be similar. What are they? First is the corresponding angles must be equal, each one of them. So there are three corresponding angles. If you see, I have taken A, B, C and D, E, F as two triangles. So I'm giving you examples of triangles, but even if it is any polygon, the corresponding angles must be equal. So in case of triangles, what will happen? A must be equal to D, B must be equal to E, and angle C must be equal to angle F, right? This is criteria number one. All the three angles should be individually, we say, correspondingly equal. Correspondingly meaning what? A corresponds to D, so those two equals are corresponding angles. So A is not corresponding to F. If A were equal to F, then we would have said A is corresponding to F. In this case, A corresponds to D, or A is mapped to D, so you can use whichever way you want. B is corresponding to E and C is corresponding to F. So this was criteria number one, guys. Criteria number two was that the ratio of the three sides, corresponding sides, that is. So for example, in this case, AB upon DE, BC upon EF, and CA upon FD. These three ratios must also be equal. So if you look at these figures here, AB by DE, I have written, BC by EF, and CA by FD. Now these values I have just calculated using a formula. I have not mentioned the values over here. So you can check if you want. This is the formula I have written. So you can see this is calculating the distance between the two points and calculating it. So I have not, mentioned any values over there. It is calculating using the formula in the software. Now the idea for this session is we are going to prove or tell you that if in case of triangles, if you want to prove that two triangles are similar, then if you just match the three angles individually, then you don't need to go for the second criteria, right? Once again, so for similarity to be established, what do we need to know? We need to know, or we do need to investigate, that the two polygons you are considering, their corresponding angles must be individually equal. That is point number one, or criteria number one. Criteria number two is their sides must be proportional. Corresponding sides must be proportional. So AB by DE in case of triangle, BC by EF, and CA by FD. These three ratios must be equal, which I am showing here. Right, so you can see the angles are clearly equal. So 65.77, 65.77, 78.69, 78.69, 35.54, and 35.54, isn't it? So they are equal, angles are equal. Now what I'm going to show you, in this case you can see the ratios are also equal, so hence you can say that the three are similar, or the two triangles are similar, right? So both the criteria, that is corresponding angles being equal, corresponding sides ratio being equal, is fulfilled. What I was trying to tell you is, even if I change this configuration of the triangles, but maintaining the angles to be equal, they still are congruent. So I'm not going to measure, or I'm not going to care about the ratio of the sides. But the best part about the triangle is, if you somehow prove that the three angles are equal individually or correspondingly, you don't need to go for the second criteria. The second criteria is automatically fulfilled. How? We will now see. So first we will validate it using this. Then we are going to prove that. So what are we going to prove, friends? We are going to prove that if there are two triangles such that in corresponding angles of the two triangles are equal, only that is given. Let's say if only that is given, then the two triangles have to be similar, meaning thereby the ratios of the corresponding sides would be proportional. You don't need to prove anything beyond that. So let me show you that it does happen. So I'm going to change the location of the side DF, but I would maintain one constraint, and that is all the three angles which are shown are not going to change. So if they are not going to change, how are the sides going to behave? The ratios, how are they going to be impacted? Let's evaluate that. So I'm going to change this location. So see, I am now bringing this line DF closer to E. Can you see, guys, the ratios are still the same. So I have maintained the three angles equal. The ratios are still the same. And if I take it away, see, if I am now enlarging this triangle, the angles are still the same, but the side lengths, you can check from here, side lengths have been modified and the ratios also have been modified, isn't it? So you see both the change in value, you see, right? So I'm changing DEF positions and see how the ratios at any given condition, it is same, right? So ratios are same. If you maintain that the angles are same, the ratios are always going to be same. But in mathematics, we know that we can't really, believe on what do we see. We haven't seen all the cases any which way. So hence, the best idea would be to give a generic proof to this. So hence, let's go to the next part of the session where we are going to prove this AAA similarity criteria. Okay, so see you there in that video.